You know, bass anglers have literally hundreds of baits to choose from. A successful day out in the water often hinges on picking the right bait for the right situation. Unfortunately, it's easy for an angler to make the wrong choice when they don't fully understand the nuances of rigging and presentations. In this Beyond the Bait video series powered by our friends at Streamlight, I'm going to offer a uniquely technical focus on the best baits for bass fishing. Along the way, I'll try to dispel many of the wives' tales, myths, and misnomers associated with bass fishing. Hi, I'm Dr. Todd Kuhn, editor in Game & Fish magazine. Come along as I attempt to help you put more fish in the boat. Now let's get to it. You know, when I talk about topwater, I get genuinely excited because probably 20 years ago, right here on the St. John's River where we are today, I caught my biggest bass ever, about 11 pounds on a topwater, an old Rapala 11G. I know for a lot of you guys might not know what that is, but it's that old-fashioned Rapala with the foil, the gold foil and the black back. And I caught that and I was so excited because when he came up and hit, she just exploded on the bait. And I set the hook and what a fight. It's one of my favorite fishing memories, and I love topwater fishing. For me, topwater fishing means a lot of things. It means poppers, chuggers, minnow baits, walking baits. It could be buzz baits, it could be frogs. It could be a wake bait. There's a lot of things that topwater means. It's not just a topwater bait per se. We're gonna show you some interesting topwater techniques today and what baits to use so you can catch more fish using topwaters. You know, choosing the right topwater bait for the conditions is more than just buying what's on sale at the local tackle shop. There's two things you need to remember, two general things you need to remember when selecting the right topwater lure for the situation that you're in. It's wind and water clarity, those two W's, just remember two W's. Wind is important because it determines what the water surface is doing. If there's no wind, the water surface is calm. If there's a lot of wind, there's chop on the water. Being successful with a topwater bait means letting the fish see and hear the bait. That's critical. Now, water clarity. Water clarity relates to the fact of how well a fish can see the bait. So you got wind and you got water clarity. If you've got a bait on top and there's so much wind that's choppy, and it's a minnow bait, for instance, the fish aren't gonna see that. They're certainly not gonna hear it. So you've got to be able to pick the right bait for the wind and the water clarity. When matching the wind with a topwater, if I'm fishing and it's very, very calm out, I'm gonna use a minnow style bait. In other words, a floating minnow bait that just twitches and it doesn't make a lot of splash, it doesn't make a lot of gurgle, it doesn't make a lot of disruption of any kind, but yet it puts off some vibration and flash when the bait is twitching in the water. As the wind picks up, and the water gets a little bit more choppy, I'll go to a prop bait, which gives you a little slosh when you're working it on top. So if there's a little bit of chop, this bait gives off some noise and it brings the fish in. Now, if it gets really, really windy and really choppy, then I'll go to a whopper plopper style bait. This is a Berkeley, but with this big giant paddle tail on it, which gives off an enormous amount of flop, 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 which in chop, it overcomes the chop and brings in the fish by the noise and the vibration. So that's how you match your vibration or your topwater bait with the wind that you're encountering. Now I've got three chugger plugs here that demonstrate the wind concept perfectly. This is a very, very small chugger plug, and we're gonna use this when it's calm, when there's very, very little wind. So as the wind kicks up and it gets a little bit more choppy, what do? We go to the exact same bait, ignore the color, only a little bit bigger, which gives off more noise and more plop. As the wind really picks up, what do? We go to the even bigger, same style popper bait, only bigger, which in the bigger chop gives off more plop and attracts more fish. It only makes sense as the water gets rougher, you want to create more churn, more attraction, more vibration, and more noise. It brings a fish in. They've got to be able to know that the bait is in the water. If they don't know the bait's out there, they're not gonna bite it. All right, so we figured out what we do with the wind. The more wind, the more commotion with the bait. What do we do about water clarity? All right, I've got two wake baits here. Yes, wake baits, not traditionally thought of as a top water plug, but they are because they work on top and they cause a lot of commotion. The bigger the bait, the more commotion. Now, when the water's clear, it's imperative that you match, that the bait looks like a forage fish, a shad, a brim, whatever it is. Because in clear water, a bass has more time to look at the bait and decide whether he wants to bite it or not. If it's an odd color, if it's an off color, say this one, that doesn't look natural, so you're gonna get less strikes on it. As the water clarity goes down, as it gets tannic, as it gets muddy, you want to go to an odd color, a bright color, a bait that they can see. This is chartreuse. You go to a brighter color so they can see it and find it in the dark, murky water. So we've matched wind, and now we've matched water clarity with our topwater baits. So we've matched our topwater plugs with wind and water clarity. Now I want to tell you about matching the rod with a topwater plug. If I'm going to throw a little itty bitty finesse bait like this little chugger, I'm going to do it on a 6'3" Fenwick Techna rod. It's a light action with a 20 series reel and probably 8-pound test line, monofilament, because it stretches well. This has little itty bitty teeny hooks. If I use this on a bait casting rod and reel or a larger spinning rod and reel, heavier line, when you set the hook, you're gonna rip the hooks out of their mouth or you're gonna bend them straight, you're never gonna do it. So match the rod with the bait that you're throwing. If I'm gonna throw a larger chugger plug, same bait, different size, you'll notice it's on a bait casting outfit, which gives me plenty of rod to make the bait work and then plenty of rod to set these larger diameter hooks, larger gauge hooks, bigger line. So match the rod with the top water plug and you're gonna catch more fish. Hey, thanks for joining us on this episode of Beyond the Baits, powered by Streamlight. I hope some of the information contained in this video will help you become a better bass fisherman. For more information about bass fishing and other outdoor topics, join us at gameandfishmag.com or pick up a copy of Game and Fish on a local newsstand near you.